Today I'm going to see if I can recover from yesterday when the mask fell off. If you go back to yesterday's video, you'll notice I left the door open to get the fumes out of here, and I blew the mask off before I could actually finish it. So that's one mistake, one failure I did. Another failure or mistake is a gruesome one. My pointy stick, of all things. I don't know if you guys know this, but I had my thumb injured pretty bad during a house fire. The tendons were cut, and they took the tendons out of my wrist, reinstalled them in my thumb. So my... touch is not exactly perfect. I had the stick pointing down, and hard to believe, at that point it was really sharp. I just cut it off. It's like a needle I printed on the 3D printer. I dropped it and it stabbed me in the foot. So I cut the point off. So that was my gruesome failure for that. But we'll get back to my issues with the backdrop. I'm gonna bring you around here and show you a couple things that I screwed up. I should have gone back and watched what I did before. One thing that I did is, getting ahead of myself, I did not put on the second set of mountains. I should have done the light gray and then the fade in, so it left the odd little stripe here and here. This should have been a really light white gray as the first layer. I skipped that and went right with the purple, and it did not help out very well, so it left a bad look to it. I did the same thing with this range of mountains too. I did not put the layer of primer light gray first. I went right with the brown, so I ended up getting this little bleed. You can even see it up here. I just got ahead of myself and should have done the light gray or the white layer first before I did that, and this would have actually disappeared. I really can't fix this that much, but what I will do is I'll redo the mountains again. I did a little test shot right here yesterday. I'll bring this mountain range up. I'll cover up this and try to hide that mistake. And I might do something over here too with another little correction. So this will actually come up and actually come across. And I'll probably bring it up, across, over, and down. And I might bring the mountain range up just a little bit right here and hide that. It's a mistake, an oops. I can live with it. It can be fixed. I actually might leave this one. This does not look bad. I just don't like this little spot right there. Down here at the end, it's not bad, I'll leave it. But again, it's not photorealistic or anything like that. It's just a backdrop for the layout. And I'm doing the exact same thing I did yesterday. If we look down here, I put the stick in my hand to swap hands, and I dropped it on my foot. So that's where I'm at today. I have an operation event tonight that I'm going to, so I'm not gonna get much done, I don't think. Today, I might come in, like I said, I'm going to come in and correct this. If I get this corrected, I will be back with you later today. If not, I might end up showing a couple photos from the operation event tonight. I'm operating on Mr. Rick Watson's layout. It is, and now that I'm put on the spot, I can't remember what the name of the layout is. California-based layout. I want to say Excelsior, but it's not. It's or Evanston. What the heck is this layout? Exeter. It's Star Trek, Starship, actually. The Exeter division or something like that. It's Southern Pacific base layout. Lots of, and combined with some Santa Fe. So it's a cool layout to operate on. I'll be operating there tonight. And if I actually take the camera or something, in a couple minutes, you'll be seeing photos of the operation.
Gonna make you famous.
Something you don't really know. If you look a little bit, you'll notice that I'll say, "Stay frosty, my friends." I usually do that towards the beginning of the video, so I don't forget to do that. So I'm going to hit you with the, "Stay frosty, my friends," and call that the end of the video. And if I have more, it gets cut in the middle. So till tomorrow or the next day.